finale. Oh, that's beautiful. Yeah. 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 Well, Bill's already done. The judges already have their drinks. We're going to be tasting them in a minute. The pressure's on. Are you nervous? Shot? In a minute. When it comes to buttering up his judges, Bill doesn't believe in butter. He believes in shots. Yeah. Look at these beautiful presentations right now. Now he's finally done. All right. Thanks for joining the party, man. I see little tiny clothesline hangers on these glasses. This is brilliant.
Let's go, Nate!
I'm not gonna lie, that's pretty sexy. The phone is sexy, though? I mean, that's not bad. That's not bad. Killing the first round of the contestants. Give it up for them. All right, let's head to the judges. That's true. All right, so, Phil.
Yeah.
Why don't we present our drinks to our judges? Bill Brand, Bluestone Bistro, everybody. Give it up for him. So Bill, tell me a little about this drink. What do we use?
So I did a spruce habanero sour. Basically a spruce essence simple syrup, habanero shrubs, a little egg white and Jameson whiskey, because we're Irish as fuck.
Oh yeah!
Woo! A little spruce twig on the side to let you smell it.
Now, Bill, I understand they call you Wild Bill. Is there some kind of story behind that?
No. Just Irish as fuck.
Very Irish.
Irish AF. Wild Bill, everybody! Yeah. Allison Ferraro from Hamlin and Ghost. Allison, would you care to present the judges with your drinks as well? Get it, girl. By the way, in the meantime, how's the food, guys? Savoy, bourbon, and rolls? What do you want?
So good.
How are your bartenders out front, by the way? Are they as good looking as this bunch? They're not bad. They get the job done, right? Yeah, they're not bad. So, Allison, what do we use in our beverage? I apologize, it was way too formal. So, Allie, what do we use in our fucking cocktail, Allie? What do we use?
We did a combination of a classic whiskey sour, classic overflow cocktail, using marmalade and Amaro Menino for the orange flavor, turning up the orange of the Jameson, shaken with egg white, some fresh lemon juice,
trust me, she's underselling it right now. All right, and now presenting to the judges, Nate Chesterton from Wellington. It is within stumbling distance down the hill from here. Just throw it out there, guys. Oh, Allie's making samples. Allie's really going for that People's Choice. Nate's also going for the People's Choice Award. I don't know what people he's going up in the land.
I've got like
but
three friends out there that are real noisy.
Nate, tell me about your drink. Tell me about your cocktail.
My cocktail is called The Legend of Kyle. It's aptly named after my older brother, Kyle. We come from a long line of whiskey drinkers, and I'm a Jameson and ginger ale kind of guy. My older brother drinks Jameson and grapefruit juice, so I used him as my inspiration for this. The guy just drinks Jameson on the rocks with like Jameson or cranberry, grapefruit, tastes great for you. And I'm like, dude, who would fucking do that? No, it doesn't sound that good. Tried it, improved on it, put some simple syrup in there, some Angostura bitters, just kind of brought the life back into it. My brother's name is tattooed right here on my forearm too, so any of you guys feel like shaking my hand, get a piece of my brother too? No, 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 no. I got shout outs, sponsors. I wanted to say Sony.
We have a time limit. Hey, listen. He brought the bell. He brought the bell for some reason. I don't know. Yeah! 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 And everybody, give it up for Sam from the shop in Troy. Yeah! Tell me a little bit about your drink. What was your inspiration? What's the name? What are we doing?
There's no name for it. I have a whiskey sour variation I made before Joe with walnut, honey, and miso to kind of play with Jameson's natural flavors. Yeah.
Lemon juice
and then a walnut and honey foam on top.
That sounds as good as you look, my friends. As good as you look. So judges, remember, everything must be kept thoroughly professional. All right, thoroughly, thoroughly professional. I'm shaking it far too long for nobody wants to see me shake. Yeah, right, yeah. You can't afford it. Most everyone can. You can. By the way, who is the homeless guy you took that jacket off of? Where did the... Just make sure he's not cold. Is all I'm saying. I'll snuggle him for one. I'll snuggle him for one. Guys, give it up for our first four contestants. Some kind of a weird Breaking Bad-esque thermos. I don't know what he's doing here. What trailer park in Arizona did you come up with that one? Look at that. Jesus, Sam's using a dropper. So Sam's, he's making a rookie teeny, which are my favorite. They're my favorite. I suck down two or three of those a night. And that's just so I can feel. It's just so I can feel everybody. That's a little insight into my world. I hope it's not too much. Meantime, oh my god, look at that. Look at that stir. Look at that length of spoon. Allie's a real size queen. Look at the length of the spoon. Oh, how much is
it?
Yep. I would expect nothing less from Nate. Did you hear him? Oh, the way you stir. He stirs me. He stirs me over. All right. Oh, Wild Bill, look at this thing. Who made that spoon for you, by the way, Wild Bill?
Jim
Marr made that spoon for you. Like got an initial on it. What's happening right now? I don't even know what these. Where are these guys getting these tools? Like I
they're all stolen, sir.
They're all stolen. Brilliant. Brilliant. They're all stolen. Let's have a little running commentary from Allison here. What are you doing? What are you doing right now?
I'm stirring.
She's stirring, everybody. She's stirring. Just so you guys know, she's stirring. Looks like Nick's putting something in the drink. What are you using right now?
I'm using some Hot Sauce Simple Whipped Cream, baby.
It's all about the cream.
Anyone want to lick the spoon?
Gross. Weird and gross. I'm not gonna lie. I'm extremely uncomfortable right now. I'm walking away from you. Sam. Where are we going right now? What are we at? No droppers. What are we at?
We dropped something.
Oh, we dropped something. All right. So we're just putting more things from mysterious medical bottles that may or may not have come from the same asylum. Nate, can you please drop those drinks off to your judges? Your judges, by the way, they're gonna judge you. I'm not gonna lie to you. They're he said, "Don't look at it." I looked at it. Not gonna lie. It's weird and different too. Oh, Wild Bill. What are we making, Wild Bill? What do we got?
You just drink these.
I should just drink this. I should just drink this. So Wild Bill won't have an entry because I'm gonna drink his drinks. Allie's putting cologne on top of her drinks. That's brilliant. I love it. I love it to death. How come you didn't master that two glasses in one hand trick I showed you? I thought I taught you that.
You know what we should have done? We should have gotten into the second boat. She'd be like,
Tuba!
I've got to eat something apparently in one of those. It's a sheriff?
Hey, Pat.
Oh, I didn't take a shot of that glass. It tastes like some kind of weird, sweet.
Made it dangerous!
Delicious.
Nate!
So, Nate, young man, come here, man.
You've got a
belt on the table. You think you're going to be the champion here this evening? Guys, I said he thinks he's going to be the champion.
They're number one!
So what do we make for the judges here? What do we make?
We made a black beard cider. So that Black Barrel's got a lot of dark flavor profile. So just wanted to compliment that with some cinnamon there. So I had some New York orchard made apples and cider from there. Then we used a little bit of Jameson and some house infused simple syrup. And we used on top of it, just to,
kill
the
game.
They're dangerous! I'm not gonna lie, he's a slut for the crowd. He's a whore for the crowd. I'm not gonna lie to you. By the way, you can catch him in the smoking alley. He's gonna be there. Whatever. I'm not judging.
They're dangerous, number one!
Alright.
They're dangerous!
So here's one of the things I love about your bar. Your bar is an old tool shop. So your bar is an old hardware shop.
Oh, shop!
And one of the things I love about it is that everything is tool themed, everything is work themed. That's one of the things I love about it. It's like, yeah, okay, you know, as a barsmith. Ridiculous, right? You know, we work. So tell me about your work this evening. Tell me about what we did right here.
Right here, what I was trying to do was a Manhattan variation. I have a vanilla saline solution. I actually add some salts, some sherry, because the Jameson Black Barrel was sherry aged, to my knowledge. And then the cacao liqueur. But I was double stirring, and I did drop an entire glass off the table, so I kind of had to fix that.
Happens to the best of us. Guess what? Happens to the best of us. Well, Sam, thank you so much for stopping up. By the way, everybody, give it up for Sam and Sean. We should also recognize that the capital region is not just about Albany, it's also about our great neighbors in Troy. Speaking of the extended capital region, Ali, tell me a little bit about your drink.
Go Ali
is from Hamlin, Ghost, and Saratoga, everybody. That would make me feel pretty good if anybody cheered for me like that. But Ali, tell me a little bit about your drink.
We're calling our Grace O'Malley. It's a twist on an old fashioned. We use the black barrel as a base with a smoky flavor. We did a toasted pecan maple syrup, a little vanilla pecan bitters, and an orange zest, and on top a little coffee and ancho chili spice to bring out the goodness.
Oh my god, that sounds so good. And last but not least, at least, Wild Bill. Wild Bill from Bluestone Bistro and Colony. We don't know why they call him Wild Bill. You know, a couple of people have, testified in court to that, but whatever, you know, we're not here to judge, other than the judges. So Wild Bill, tell me about your drink.
So with the Black Barrel, I did a family made maple syrup infused with American oak, Boomtown Bitters, which is a vanilla bitters,
And then. By the way, guys, I have never seen anybody look nerdier with a wrestling belt around them than they do. In the immortal words,
so where
the Rachel Martin, vests are there to protect you from waves, life vests protect you from drowning,
5 minutes from here.
And sweater vests protect you from pretty girls. So, there you go, everybody. Everybody, give it up for our bartenders. You should probably organize
it.
How long has
it been in there?
We're working on it!
Okay, okay. Yeah, alright. I haven't been in there since. I mean, you know, I used to go in a lot when it was Justin, and it kind of gradually went down.
Tell us a little bit more about your drink. I'm sorry, man.
I haven't been in since they changed their
names.
Okay, I got to check that out.
Some black barrel,
glad to hear that. Stepping up their game.
Thank you so much, my friend. I'm sorry I made you repeat.
Gradually, like, let it go.
No, no, no. I'm standing in front. I'm standing in front. Guys. Guys. Listen, I don't know. I want to say a big thank you to Savoy Tap Room and Bourbon and Wolf. Fill the tummies a little bit, so you know, okay, we'll keep drinking. All right, I'm gonna need these lazy sons of guns to get their stuff out of here, and I need.